Hello students, today in this video we are going to learn the short answer type questions, reasons and descriptive questions for the chapter 2. The chapter name is Microorganisms, Friend and Foe, class 8, subject science. In the previous video we had already seen the small exercise or objective question answers. So now let me start with the short answer type questions. First question in that, answer the following questions in short. And these questions can be asked in 2 marks. In this first question, where do microorganisms live? So microorganisms live under all types of environment, ranging from ice cold climate to hot springs and deserts to marshy lands. We had already seen what is marshy land. A wetland or an area of land where water covers ground for long period of time, that is marshy land. So microorganisms live in these marshy lands also. They are also found inside the body of animals including humans. And some microorganisms grow on other organisms while others exist freely. And some can live alone while others may live in colonies or in groups. So this is where the microorganisms live. The next question, state the commercial and medicinal use of microorganisms. So the commercial use of microorganisms. In that first one, they are useful in production of various dairy products such as curd, cheese, paneer, etc. The microorganisms are helpful to make these dairy products. The next is, yeast is used in the baking industry for making breads, pastries and cakes. The next use is, microorganisms are used on the large scale for the production of alcohol, wine and acetic acid, that is vinegar. So this is the commercial use of microorganisms. Now medicinal use of microorganisms. So in that first one, the production of antibiotics can be done by culture of specific microorganisms. Some antibiotics are made from these microorganisms. A number of antibiotics are being produced from bacteria and fungi, and such antibiotics are used to treat or cure different diseases. The next another use is, the vaccines are made on a large scale from microorganisms to protect humans and other animals from several diseases. So these are the medicinal use of microorganisms. The next question is, how is the vaccine produced and how is it helpful to prevent the occurrence of disease? So let me find how this vaccine is produced or discovered. So vaccine is produced with the use of dead or weakened disease causing microorganisms under the observation of experts. In that they had done the dead or weakened microbes introduced as vaccine in a healthy body. The body fights and kills them by producing suitable antibodies which are produced by the body, our body. The antibodies remain in the body and we are protected from the disease-causing microbes. And this is how the vaccine helpful to us to prevent from the occurrence of disease. So it is helpful to prevent occurrence of disease. The next question is, state any 4 usefulness of bacteria. So the usefulness of bacteria are, first one, to make milk products like curd, cheese and paneer. Next is nitrifying bacteria. The example of that is rhizobium fix atmospheric nitrogen into soil and make the soil fertile. Nitrifying bacteria, they are fixing the atmospheric nitrogen into soil and which helps the plant to grow properly and make the soil fertile. These bacteria, they decompose the sewage waste and the other organic waste and convert them into simple substance. And it is also helpful to prepare vaccines and antibiotics, as we had seen in the earlier question, previous question. The next question, state any four uses of fungi. So the uses of fungi. That first one is, it is used to prepare bread and a cake in a bakery. The next is yeast. Yeast is also a kind of fungi. So yeast is used to prepare alcohol by fermentation process on natural sugars, wine from fruit juices, and dhoklas, idli, dosa, from the mixture of flours of rice and pulse. We had seen the fermentation process in the chapter explanation, and this fermentation process, this fungi helps us to make this fermented food. The example of fermented food is also given to you, that is dhokla, idli, dosa, theta. The next use of fungi is penicillin is obtained from the fungus penicillium. The another use is some species of fungi known as mushroom are used as a food. We are taking it as a food. So this is how we are using fungi, or fungi is helpful to us. The next question, state the different vaccines given to children and the disease against which the vaccines protect. So here the different name of the vaccines and the disease against which this vaccine protect us or children, that is given to you. First is BCG. So it protects against tuberculosis. Next is DPT. It protects against diphtheria, pertussis, tetanus. The next is polio. In that, drops are given to you. So it protects against polio. Next is measles and smallpox. It protects against measles and smallpox. Next vaccine is typhoid vaccine. So it protects against typhoid disease. The next is hepatitis B vaccine. So it protects against hepatitis. So these are the vaccines which protect against this disease. The next question, how does common cold spread and how do you prevent the spread of it? So when a person suffering from common cold sneezes, fine droplets of moisture carrying thousands of virus are spread in the air. When a person sneezes, a small droplets of moisture which carries thousands of virus that are spread in the air. And the virus may enter the body of a healthy person while he is breathing. So this is how the virus spread from the person who is suffering from common cold to a healthy person. And to prevent this, we should keep a handkerchief on the nose and mouth while sneezing. And it is better to keep a distance from the infected person. So this is how we can prevent ourselves from this common cold. The next is, how is housefly responsible for the spread of disease? So housefly is a carrier of disease causing microbes. First, these flies sit on the garbage and animal excreta. The pathogens or microbes stick on their bodies, and when these flies sit on uncovered food, they may transfer these pathogens or disease-causing microbes. Whoever eat the contaminated food or this type of food is likely to get sick, and by this way, the housefly is responsible for the spread of a disease. The next question is, how can we control the spread of malaria or dengue? So, the female Anopheles mosquito act as a carrier of malarial parasites, and female Aedes mosquito act as a carrier of dengue virus. These both are the carrier of this malaria and dengue disease. To control the spread of malaria and dengue, we should control the carriers, and this can be done by the following. Now we will see. So first, all mosquitoes breed in water. They are rise in water, increase in numbers in water, collected water. Hence, one should not let water to collect anywhere in coolers, tires, flower pot, etc. And by keeping the surrounding clean, and dry, we can prevent mosquitoes from breeding, and hence we can control the spread of malaria and dengue. The next is explain in brief microbial disease in cattle. So several microbes cause disease in other animals along with human. The example is given, anthrax is a dangerous cattle disease caused by a bacterium Bacillus anthracis. That we had seen what happened in the anthrax. So foot and mouth disease of cattle is caused by a virus. So these are the microbial disease in the cattle. We had seen that in anthrax, a skin form presents with a small blister with surrounding swellings, and then of that one often turns into a ulcer with a black center. So it is a dangerous disease in the cattle. The next is explain about plant disease. So several microorganisms cause disease in plants like wheat, rice, potato, sugarcane, orange, apple, etc. And the disease reduce the yield of crops, or it gives less amount of crops. And some such plant disease are given to you. And by which organism they are spreading is also given to you, and mode of transmission is given. So first one is citrus canker. So it is spread by bacteria, and the mode of transmission is air. The next is rust of wheat. It is spread by fungi, and the mode of transmission of this disease is air and seeds. The next is yellowing mosaic of bhindi or okra. So it happens in the bhindi or okra lettuce finger, and it is spread due to the virus, and the mode of transmission is itself insects. So the plant disease can be controlled by the use of certain chemicals which kill the microbes. This is how we can control this plant disease. Next is write a short note on nitrogen fixation. So nitrogen fixation occurs by two ways. In that first one is chemical fixation. So very less amount of atmospheric nitrogen gets fixed through the action of lightning. In this chemical process occur during the lightning, and by this lightning the atmospheric nitrogen gets fixed into the soil. So first is chemical fixation. The next is biological fixation. In this biological fixation, the rhizobium lives in the root nodules of leguminous plant such as beans and peas or pulses, and with which it has a symbiotic relationship. They both are depend on each other, that we had seen in the chapter. So rhizobium involve in the fixation of nitrogen in leguminous plants or pulses, and blue-green algae, the example of this blue-green algae is also given to you, that is Anabaena, and nostoc also fix nitrogen from soil. So this is how the nitrogen fixation occurs. That is, two methods are there, chemical fixation and biological fixation. The next question is given to you, explain giving scientific reasons. In that first one, microorganisms are considered as friends and enemies of human beings. So let we see how these are friends and enemies of human being. So first, microorganisms are useful in many ways to human beings and other organisms. They are useful to make curd from milk, to prepare idli and dosa, and to bring fermentation, to prepare antibiotics, vaccines, etc. These are the usefulness or importance of microorganisms, how they are friends to us. Now next is third number, some microorganism causes disease like malaria, cholera, tuberculosis, typhoid, polio in human, and thus they are harmful also. So due to microorganisms usefulness as well as harmfulness, they are considered as friends and enemies of human being. The next question is, bacteria are universal. So let me see how these are the universal. So bacteria are found on the soil, in the soil, in water, in air, and in bodies of organisms. That means these are bacteria are present everywhere. The bacteria are present in snow-covered regions and deserts also. There is no place on the earth where bacteria are absent, so bacteria are universal, or you can say omnipresent. So this is how the bacteria are universal. The next reason is, virus is called a connecting link between living and non-living. So virus is a microscopic, it does not show any biological activity in free state. Thus, it behaves as non-living. When it is in free state, it is not showing any biological activity, and it is living as a non-living object or non-living thing. It reproduces only inside the cells of the host organism, which may be a bacterium, plant, or animal. When it enters into the another organism, that is called also as a host organism, it might be bacteria, plant, or animal, it reproduces inside the cells of that host organism. And thus, exhibiting a biological activity, it behaves like a living organism. As virus shows the quality of both living and non-living, it is called a connecting link between living and non-living. Next is, algae are autotrophic. So there is a chlorophyll in the cells of algae. In algae, chlorophyll is also present. They produce organic substance by photosynthesis in the presence of sunlight with the help of chlorophyll. Algae are making their food by the process of photosynthesis, and they use this organic material as a food. As algae prepare their food by themselves, they are known as autotrophic. So this is why the algae are autotrophic. The next is, water should be boiled and then used during an epidemic. So during an epidemic, microorganisms enter water reservoirs through the clothes, utensils, excreta, urine, vomit, etc. of the patient. And water in reservoirs get contaminated or get polluted. And diseases are caused by drinking such type of water. So on boiling water, the microorganisms that are present in the type of water that are destroyed. And so water should be boiled and then used during an epidemic. So during this time, you have to also drink the boiled water. The next is, it is necessary to give polio vaccine to the children. Why it is necessary? So, children have very little immunity. A person becomes crippled because of polio. He may not be able to do a work, different types of work as the normal person do. So, after the stroke of polio, it is not possible to cure it by medicine, and the condition of the child becomes pitiable. So after one time the stroke of the polio comes into the person, it is not possible to cure that person by medicine or any other condition. So on giving polio vaccine to a child, the defense mechanism of body prepares resistive chemical and makes the virus of polio completely inactive. So from the childhood, we are giving polio vaccine to the children. And thus, for the protection against polio, it is necessary to give polio vaccine to the children. It is a precaution against the polio. Next is, food should always be covered. So the answer is, we had already seen. Let me see. Housefly acts as a carrier of disease causing microbes and responsible to spread disease like cholera, typhoid, etc. The flies sit on the garbage and animal excreta, and pathogens or disease causing microbes stick to their bodies. Now, when these flies sit on uncovered food, they may transfer these pathogens which are on their body. And whoever eat this type of contaminated food is likely to get sick. And so for to keep this food safe from contamination, it should be always be covered. So here the reasons get over. Now next we see descriptive type questions. In that first one, write a short note on nitrogen cycle. So let us see about the nitrogen cycle. So atmosphere has 78% of nitrogen gas. This nitrogen is one of the essential constituent or part of proteins, chlorophyll, nucleic acids and vitamins in the living organism. And the atmospheric free nitrogen cannot be directly taken by plants and animals. So for that, certain bacteria are there. So certain bacteria and blue-green algae present in the soil fix the atmospheric nitrogen and convert it into compound of nitrogen, that is ammonia. It converts into the form of ammonia. Once the nitrogen is converted into the usable compounds, it can be utilized by the plants from the soil through their root system or through their roots. Then after this nitrogen is then used for the synthesis of plant proteins or proteins in the plants and in the different compounds. Now the animals who are feeding on the plants get this protein and the other nitrogen compounds from these plants. And when plants and animals die, bacteria and fungi that are present in the soil, they act as the decomposers and convert this nitrogenous waste into the nitrogenous compound. And such type of compounds are used by the plants again. Now, how this nitrogen will get fixed again in the atmosphere? So certain other bacteria that are also known as denitrifying bacteria, they convert some part of nitrogenous compound into nitrogen gas again, and which goes back into the atmosphere. And as a result of that, the percentage of nitrogen in the atmosphere remains more or less constant. It remains almost constant, that is 78%. Here the nitrogen cycle is shown to you. Starting from here, the compounds of nitrogen in the soil that are taken by the plants, then after animals that eat plants get the nitrogenous compound from the plants, and when these plants and animals get die, the nitrogenous waste from their excretion and death, they are get back again into the soil. Now this nitrogen from compound from the soil, some bacteria turn this compound of nitrogen into gaseous nitrogen, and which again went back into the atmosphere. Now from the atmosphere to the land. So this one nitrogen fixation process that we had seen, by the lightning process, the nitrogen, atmospheric nitrogen, get fixed into the soil here. And some nitrogen fixing bacteria and blue-green algae also fix this atmospheric nitrogen into the soil, and bacteria in turn fix nitrogen into the nitrogenous compound. So this is how the nitrogen cycle works. So now by one animation, let me see the nitrogen cycle.
Ah!
the next question in question answer details is explain the methods of food preservation. So for answer that, spoilage of food prevented by preventing the growth of microbes in it such a way that its nutritive value is maintained. To preserve the food or to prevent the food from getting spoiled, we have to stop or prevent the growth of microbes, and this is called food preservation. And the common methods of food preservation is given to you in that first one is chemical method. For that, sodium benzoate or sodium metabisulfate are the common preservatives used in the germs and squashes to check their spoilage. We had seen what is squash. So it is a syrup which is usually fruit flavored and made from fruit juice, water and sugar. The next is preservation by salt. So salting is used to preserve amla, raw mangoes, tamarind, etc. Meat and fish are covered with dry salt to check the growth of bacteria. In this method salting, sea salt is used which have undergone the process of drying. The maximum moisture content in this type of food is about 0.3%. And in salting, food is surrounded in salt. So this is the preservation method of raw food items. The next is preservation by sugar. So jams, jellies and squashes are preserved by sugar. And sugar reduces the moisture content which inhibits the growth of bacteria which spoil food. So by sugar we can also preserve the food. The next is preservation by oil and vinegar. So use of oil and vinegar prevent the spoilage of pickles because the bacteria cannot live in such an environment, in oily and environment where the vinegar is present. The vegetable, fruits, fish and meat are often preserved by this method. The next method is heat and cold methods or heat and cold treatment. In this, milk is boiled and then keep in refrigerator, and food is also keep in the refrigerator. Low temperature inhibits or stops the growth of microbes. It slows down the growth of microbes. The next is storage and packing. So dry fruits and even vegetables are sealed in the airtight packets to prevent the attack of microbes. So by this method we can also preserve the food. So these are the different methods of food preservation. So here the long question answer for this chapter 2, microorganisms, friend and foe, gets over. These questions you have to write in your notebook, and this is your homework. And this file you can find in the study material in our app. Thank you.